Dear students, in this class we will discuss about the two different termination processes of transcription in prokaryotes. They are called as rho dependent and rho independent termination of transcription. So transcription is the process in which it is the first step in protein synthesis, and it is a process in which a new RNA called as mRNA is being synthesized based on or complementary to a DNA template, which is the gene. And this is being catalyzed by the enzyme DNA dependent RNA polymerase. And there are three steps in transcription, that is initiation, then elongation and termination. So we are only dealing with the last part, that is termination. That means how this process ends, how the newly synthesized mRNA is freed from the DNA template. Now, so this is being carried out by the RNA polymerase enzyme itself, which plays a role in the two principal mechanisms of transcription termination, and this has been extensively studied in E. coli. So this classification is based on the requirement of an additional protein, which is a transcription factor, which is called as rho, or it is a termination factor. So there are some transcription processes in prokaryotes which require this rho protein for termination. They are called as rho dependent terminations, whereas there are some transcription processes in eukaryotes which are independent of this protein rho. They are said to be rho independent termination. And most of the operons which are studied in E. coli, they are rho independent. That means most of them are possessing rho independent termination sites. In eukaryotes, the mechanisms for termination of transcription, they appear for different types of RNA polymerase. There are different types of RNA polymerases in eukaryotes, so that we will deal with later. Now we focus on the prokaryotic termination. So the first one, that is rho independent termination. A gene or an RNA transcribed from it, a prokaryotic gene or an RNA transcribed from it, which is based on or which is working on the rho independent mechanism, will have two characteristic features. The first one is that this transcribed RNA, so those which depend on rho independent termination, in them the transcribed RNA will have a series of U residues at the end. You can see at the 3 dash end there will be a series of uridine residues. So here you can see it. There will be a series of uridine residues at the 3 dash end of the transcribed mRNA. So that is one of the features. Second one, just preceding this U region, there will be a GC rich region. So we will go to that. So look at this mRNA. This is the mRNA we were mentioning about. So at the 3 dash end of this mRNA, there is a polyuridine sequence. And just before that, you can see a GC rich sequence. Now, what is the peculiarity of this GC rich sequence? So we will go to that. This GC rich region is self-complementary. Even though it is having many intervening nucleotides, it is a complementary region. So when such a self-complementary region of a growing RNA chain is synthesized, these complementary regions will base pair with one another, forming a stem loop structure. So we will go to a stem loop here. This was the original mRNA with polyuridine residues at the 3 dash end, and preceding it there is this GC rich region. Now you just see what happens to this mRNA. This GC rich region, being self-complementary, is forming a looped structure. That is, this G, it is base pairing with this C. So G base pairs with this C. The C will base pair with G like that. So what here they form is a loop like structure. So that is why it is said to be self complementary. So one region here and the adjacent region are complementary. Here you can see this region and this region are complementary. This and this are complementary, but this is not. So this will look like a loop and this will form the stem. So this is called as a stem loop structure. So the complementary regions will base pair to form the stem, and this intervening sequences here, they will form the loop. So these are the two characteristics of gene or an RNA which is dependent on rho independent termination, which resorts to rho independent termination. So what did we say? There will be a polyuridine tail at the 3' end, and there will be a GC rich self complementary region just preceding this uridine region, and it will undergo base pairing to form a stem loop structure. Now we will see what happens. So this stem loop structure, so here you can see the stem loop. This is the stem loop. This is the DNA molecule or the gene, and this is the template DNA strand. This is the newly synthesized mRNA strand. This is the 3' end of the newly synthesized mRNA strand. So now you see, and this enzyme is RNA polymerase. So the stem loop structure which is just formed will interact with the RNA polymerase. So the stem loop structure interacts with the RNA polymerase, causing it to stop. The RNA polymerase has to stop once it reaches the stem loop structure. So that is what happens. So the formation of the loop will prevent further moving of the RNA polymerase. So it stops its activity, and there comes the end of transcription, which is called as termination. And in addition, there is one more peculiarity. That is, I told you at this 3' end, there is a poly U region, and in the template DNA strand there will be poly A. So there will be A residues in the template strand and U residues at the mRNA strand. And though they base pair, this base pairing is extremely unstable compared to other types of Watson-Crick base pairs. So AU base pairing is weaker compared to the other base pairs, other Watson-Crick base pairs. So this also makes this bond weakened. So what happens? This RNA will separate from DNA. So these two features, that is the formation of the stem loop as well as the weakened UA interactions, permit the release of RNA chain from this DNA. And the RNA polymerase, because of the stem loop, the RNA polymerase stopped moving further, and because of this weak interaction, the mRNA transcript is released from the DNA. So this is called as rho independent. Now we go to rho dependent termination. So here, in this, there is a protein factor involved. It is called as rho. So here you can see this rho. This is the newly synthesized mRNA. This is the template DNA. This is RNA polymerase. So this mRNA has got a binding sequence for this rho protein. And what happens? At the time of termination, the rho protein binds to this site, and it travels along the newly synthesized RNA. So actually what is happening is, it is chasing this RNA polymerase. And in addition to the chasing by rho, here also a stem loop will be formed. In this RNA also there will be formation of a stem loop, which is slightly different from the stem loop in the other kind of termination, that is rho independent termination, but still here also a loop will be formed. So since the loop forms, the RNA polymerase is paused, just as we saw in the other one. When a loop forms, the RNA polymerase cannot move further. So what happens? The RNA polymerase is slowed down so that the rho can chase it and come near it. Okay. So this will allow the rho protein to catch up with the RNA polymerase and displace the RNA polymerase from the template strand. So the enzyme will be displaced by this rho, which has now chased it and come near it. So for that, how can this rho protein displace the RNA polymerase? It is because this rho has got an ATP dependent helicase activity. So it can also dislodge the mRNA from the DNA. So here, whether the transcription is terminated or not seems to depend on whether rho moves sufficiently fast to catch up with the polymerase. So it is the efficiency of rho to catch up with the polymerase that will determine termination. So consequently, the pausing of polymerase during elongation is thought to be an important component of rho dependent termination as well as rho independent termination. That is, the formation of the loop is one of the factors which will cause the stopping of the RNA polymerase, whether it is dependent on rho or it is not dependent. So these are the two types of termination which we can see in prokaryotes, that is rho dependent termination and rho independent termination of transcription.